She sat in a bathtub with porcelain tiles, her hands resting on either sides. A glass half full with wine sat alongside, but the color red was growing faster on the inside. She held the blade so tight it was cutting into her palm, but the pain was welcome. It made her feel calm. Because any pain was better than that pain. Any pain was better than being called insane. To even think that this is rape, you are married to him for God's sake. You are his wife. He is simply claiming his right. Your duty is to obey his commands, so stop behaving so uptight. For many years, her friends and family told her that's how men show love. It's not wrong. But the bruises on her body stood out to sing a different song. So she slid into the bathtub with absolutely no confusion. For in her mind, her problems had only one solution. She willed her hands to come together. One held the blade, which was pointed at the other. But as the blade made its first shallow cut, an uneasy feeling churned deep in her gut. Her daughter's face came to her mind, asleep in the adjacent room with a face so kind. Her palm fell automatically onto her pregnant belly, and she was reclaimed by her conflicting mind. A stray tear streaked down her cheek, leaving behind a trace. She knew what had to be done, the resolution now clear on her face. There were so many truths left unspoken, so many hearts yet to be mended, which like her own were left broken. If she could just tell those suffering silently, "You're worthy of love." The words never spoken to her, "You're worthy of love." To the ones sold in the name of marriage, "You're worthy of love." To the many Nirbhayas with their untold stories, "You're worthy of love." To the ones demeaned for speaking up, "You're worthy of love." To the ones considered a burden, "You're worthy of love." We are all worthy of being loved. So she stepped out with sweaty, clammy hands and a small family of three to make everyone aware that rape or violence of any kind is not the fault of you and me. Listen to your conflicting mind and make the right decision. Live to tell the tale and provide the despair with an alternate solution. Thank you.